were now in tune, you were now in tune, you were now in, you were now in tune to the motherfucking greatest. You were now in tune to the motherfucking greatest. You were now in tune to the motherfucking, you were now in, you were now in tune.
I'd like to talk about one thing, man. Ines Sainz. Alright, Ines Sainz is a Mexican reporter who calls herself the hottest reporter in Mexico. Now, she went over to America, to the NFL to be specific, in the New York Jets locker room and did an interview. Apparently, this wasn't like any other interview. She was being sexually harassed, and she says, open quote, I was dying of embarrassment, close quote. So I'm guessing it was something really dramatic and really serious. Maybe she got touched or something. I don't know. Come to find out, it was a few gestures and a series of remarks in terms of sexual harassment, which is crazy. You're going to file for sexual harassment, and then you're going to make a big deal by saying, I was dying of embarrassment. Well, look, if you guys know who I'm talking about, according to the picture she takes, she had it coming. She was asking for it. Now, make a picture in your mind, all right? You got two pictures. One picture depicts of how a real reporter should look like, how a professional reporter should look like, and the other picture is pictures of Ines Sainz. Now, you would realize if you have any knowledge of what a reporter should look like, and then you look at her, you would know straight off the bat that that is not how a reporter should dress. I'm going to show you an interview. Now, when you watch this, I want you to consider every factor. Look at her, look how she's dressing. You'll know exactly what I'm talking about, man. Just listen. Just her stupid voice, man. Just listen to her.
The NFL is investigating allegations that some of the New York Jets sexually harassed sports reporter Ines Sainz. Jets head coach Rex Ryan allegedly engaged in weird on-field antics with Sainz during practice on Saturday, and others hit her with catcalls and suggestive comments when she entered the locker room afterwards. With me now to talk about the ordeal in a primetime exclusive is Ines Sainz. Ines, what type of bad behavior and comments were you subjected to at practice on Saturday?
Hi, hello, nice to salute you. Well, what I try to explain is that on Saturday when I arrived to the locker rooms, what I pretend to do is not...
Mexican reporter pretending Mexican Barney is possible, you know. They got a Mexican dollar, the peso. So that must mean the Mexican Barney is hard working, especially in the summertime, and very cheap.
To hear anything and go straight to make my job with the interview with Mark Sanchez. But obviously in the environment, we feel that everybody start to make noises and expressions about myself. But I have 8 years working in this kind of things and in Mexico and in Europe and in other parts. So I decided that it's better go to focus on my job and don't pay attention. What really happened next is that one of my colleagues, one of the media workers, also a female, came with me and told me, I really sorry, it mustn't happen, and I'm very, very feel bad for you.
Not me. If that lady really feels sorry for her, she probably dressed like a hoe too.
So I respond her that it doesn't matter, don't worry, I'm not pay attention.
I not pay attention? Yeah, we got a preschool graduate for a sports reporter.
Read a book.
I only want to make my job and that's it.
I only want to do my job and that's it.
But yeah. I really think that she here and the rest of the media here.
I think that she here and the rest of the media here. I think that she heard and the rest of the media heard. Learn English before you cross the border.
Yeah, hear a lot of things that I didn't hear.
They did. But you tweeted that you were dying of embarrassment, but you never felt attacked. So, but let me ask you something else. Now, were you encouraged to call yourself the hottest reporter in Mexico? Is that your, did you give yourself that name or did your employers tell you to do that?
Well, actually, in Mexico, it's not as common as here to get to the locker rooms. When I say I am embarrassment, I feel uncomfortable here. It's because I was in a very complicated situation because it's a lot of men around.
And what's the problem? All of a sudden, you're out of your element? I bet she's dying from embarrassment every time she rides the football player, huh?
One of those are naked, so my cameraman say, don't turn around here, don't turn around there. So I didn't.
Oh, wow, great. Now she has a fascia recording her discussions.
But that is not the important point. The important point is what they are saying in the minute that I was in the in the locker room. So I must say that I tried, or I pretend to not hear anything. I pretend to not move and not to try to be
Ines, what I'm driving at is that some people are saying that when you call yourself the hottest reporter in Mexico, and you're wearing tight jeans, etc., that people say you shouldn't be shocked if the men respond to you with catcalls. How do you respond to that?
No, absolutely no. I think I have one style. I make over 250 interviews, one-on-one with the best players in the world for the different sports, and it's my style.
And that's why you shouldn't be a reporter.
I only use for one kind of things.
Don't forget your night job.
I use the jeans, I use a regular shirt, and I made the job. When I need to do another kind of covers, I dress different. But I don't believe that my dress is the point of the discussion.
What are you talking about? That's why you got harassed, because the way you dress. And what's discussion? It's not the problem for the discussion, it's discussion. I'm gonna tell you right now, you sound like a Mexican Hitler, man.
Here, because I do not anything.
And I didn't do it. What are you saying, man? Come on. Wow. Wow.
Anything to provoke the team or the players.
If you really believe that the way you were dressing wasn't gonna cause any provocations, you must really be a hoe, for real. And I guess LeBron James never saw it coming either, huh? How can you really believe that you didn't propagate anything? Come on, man. One girl comes through that locker, guess what? They're gonna look, and they're gonna say something. I'm pretty sure Mexicans are more hornier than people in America. I'm very sure. So you knew, you had it coming, and you knew that you were gonna provoke something. You just wanted to be cute, and that's why you shouldn't be a reporter. It's about professionalism, skank.
I believe that I only go to work my job, and if the jeans are or not in the way that they like it or not, that's not my problem.
Okay, thanks very much, Ines, for checking in with us on this problem.
No, thank you.
Okay, good
thank
luck.
Thank you, and I want to, yes, only if you...
Wow. You know, I'm just done with this whole topic, because this is just utterly stupid. She had it coming, alright? She's a hoe. She doesn't dress like a reporter, you know? She dresses promiscuous looking, you know? So, thus, everybody wants to do her. The businessman wants to do her. The people in the train want to do her. Football players want to do her. Even soccer players want to do her. You know, you're just a hoe. If you don't really believe, if you really believe that the way you're dressing wasn't really gonna cause problems, if you can't really see that, you must be a hoe. Like, you must have been a stripper or something, or you must have another job, because you're not built to be a reporter. Leave it to the veterans, like, you know, Barbara Walters and Joy, you know, from CNN, you know. I don't want to see you reporting, because you're just a disgrace to female reporters, because you dress like a skank. You know what I mean? Anyone who want have something to say about this, you know, you can drop me a video comment or send me a comment. youtube.com/eryda vision. Erada Vision, you know. Just get at me. Voice your opinions, whether positive or negative, but she's just stupid, man. And she shouldn't be a reporter. It's bad enough that there's very few female reporters out there, and she has to disgrace them by dressing like a hoe. Come on, man.
Your daddy knows that you sucking down chocolate like daddy-o.